Every human being on this earth knows that life is not without pain. For most of us, it's an inconvenience, a trial to be endured or avoided. But there are a select few who seek it out, who use it as a tool to create something so beautiful that it transcends this world and makes them immortal.
Paris is, well, let's just say that wherever you go in the world, Paris stays with you, for Paris is a movable feast.
That's beautiful.
Well, it's Hemingway, not me. He did have a way with words. He also had a way with women.
So what are Henry Morgan's must-sees in Paris?
In my humble opinion, the single best thing to do in Paris is get lost.
Lost?
Yes. Wake up, start walking in any direction, really, and get lost. Wander the streets until you're so terribly weak that you have no choice but to stop at the nearest cafe and order something wonderful to eat along with a glass or two of wine, and then set back out into the city and do it all over again. But know that this regimen works best only if done with someone you find very special.
Sounds nice.
There are moments in all of our lives when we are compelled to ask ourselves, how far are we willing to go for what we want?
Valerie? It's Henry. Our minds now? Are troubled by the emptiness.
Collecting names of the lovers that went wrong. Incredible. The lovers that
went wrong. How much are we willing to risk, to sacrifice, to endure?
We are the reckless, we are the wild youth, chasing visions of our futures.
Because it's one thing to yearn for something. Quite another to find the strength to achieve it.